Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
I think the key part is education, educating people that their food choices really impact not just themselves, but also the world around them. So I think it's important to create incentives for people to have access to healthy food.
Mark Pierschel, An Altruistic Spirit for Animals, Humans, and the Planet, Part 2 of 2. Continue watching to find out more.
Today's show will be presented in German and English, with subtitles in Arabic, Oloxis, also known as Vietnamese, Chinese, English, French, German, Hindi, Indonesian, Korean, Mongolian, Persian, Portuguese, Spanish, and Thai. Seien Sie gegrüßt, edle Zuschauer. Ich bin Claudia aus Berlin, Deutschland. Unser Volk wünscht Ihnen, meine Freunde, einen ruhigen und erfreulichen Tag. Willkommen zurück zu Teil 2 unserer Sendung über Mark Pierschel, einen Dokumentarfilmer, Mitbegründer des veganen Online-Shops Roots of Compassion und Autor des veganen Kochbuchs Vegan – Vegane Lebensweise für alle, von dem bereits über 50.000 Exemplare verkauft wurden. In unserer letzten Folge präsentierten wir Marks neuesten Dokumentarfilm The End of Meat. Und die Besucher der Premiere ließen unsere Zuschauer weltweit an ihren positiven Kommentaren teilhaben. Begleiten wir Mark nun auf seiner Reise, die inspiriert ist von seiner Vision von einer fleischfreien Welt.
I started Roots of Compassion, which is a collective, and my idea was to spread the ideas of veganism and animal rights, because that was in early 2001 when we started, and back then in Germany at least, the idea of veganism and animal rights wasn't really known to people, so I wanted to raise awareness, and we printed t-shirts and made buttons and went to protests and concerts with literature and just doing outreach and raising awareness, and yeah, that's something I continue to do with my films and my books.
Die meisten etablierten Gesundheitsorganisationen in der westlichen Welt erklären, dass eine gut geplante vegane Ernährung durchaus zuträglich und nahrhaft ist. Aber dies ist der breiten Öffentlichkeit immer noch nicht allgemein bekannt. Mark geht näher darauf ein, wie wir seiner Meinung nach die gesunde vegane Botschaft wirksam fördern können.
I think for me personally, I'm just trying to lead by example. So I'm trying to live a more healthy lifestyle, eating very consciously, eating a whole plant food diet. And yeah, I think that's the best thing we can do, because good vegan food is really convincing, or a good way to convince people that this is really something people can sustain.
Der Öffentlichkeit Wege hin zu mehr Mitgefühl aufzueigen, kann eine große Herausforderung sein. Mark spricht darüber, welche Wege erfolgreich sein können.
There's different approaches that work for people. So in my films, I'm trying to just present the arguments for a plant-based lifestyle, and then people can choose for themselves if they want to adopt these changes or make a change for their own diet. I think the key part is education, educating people that their food choices really impact not just themselves, but also the world around them. So I think it's important to create incentives for people to have access to healthy food, and also for people to know what a healthy diet is and what it consists of, because there's a lot of misinformation from corporations that want to sell their products, but also from lobby groups, politicians. So I think it's key that more organizations do outreach and inform people what a healthy diet is, and that a plant-based diet is a very healthy diet.
In seinem Dokumentarfilm The End of Meat stellt Mark Laborfleisch vor.
In my film, I'm also exploring the idea of cultured meat or clean meat, which is meat that's grown in a laboratory, or when the technology is finished, it's actually going to be something that's similar to a brewery, where people grow meat in huge tanks, and so they can make meat product that we know now from these cells. I didn't really know too much about the technology before I did the film, and then I met all these companies and startups and scientists working on this technology. And I think it's a really important alternative that's has a way better ecological footprint, and of course it doesn't harm animals.
Ein weiteres klares Beispiel für Alternativen zu tierischen Produkten ist die Züchtung von Rotalgen im Meer.
So in the film we're also looking at dalts, which is an algae from the ocean. It's harvested, and when you deep fry it, it tastes like bacon. And so we visited scientists in Portland, Oregon, who are working on this, and they discovered that it tastes like bacon, and they're working on products to market this product and, basically to make a bacon alternative and present it to people. And I tried it myself, and it does taste like bacon. So maybe that shows that there's alternatives we don't know yet that are, that could be introduced into the future and present an alternative to meat products.
Fröhliche Zuschauer, wir gehen kurz hinaus an die frische Luft. Bitte bleiben Sie bei Supreme Master Television. Willkommen zurück, liebe Zuschauer. Die Öffentlichkeit fragt Mark immer wieder nach seiner Vision von einer fleischfreien Welt.
I often get the question, when do you envision the end of meat? And I don't have an exact date, but I feel like if I look at the development in Germany, it has progressed so quickly in just a few years that I'm very hopeful that this trend will spread to other countries. And we see that in the US, and we see that in other countries in Europe, that more and more people are turning to a plant-based diet and they're interested in it. Maybe they're not vegan yet. There's this group called flexitarians, so people that are actively reducing their meat or animal product consumption. And so this helps the whole industry to grow because it's an incentive for companies to produce more plant-based products. And I think that's something that will continue to grow in the future, and maybe then one day there will be no more animal products.
Mark wies darauf hin, dass der Impulsgeber, der den veganen Trend in Deutschland so schnell wachsen ließ, schneller als in den USA, die Erkenntnis über den Zusammenhang zwischen Veganismus und Gesundheit war.
One key development in Germany was the connection of health to veganism. That's what enabled this to enter the mainstream. Then there was the focus on health, and we got these cookbooks that were all promising, a healthy lifestyle, basically, and that's what got the people interested in the first place, and that then helped continue to grow the movement.
Mark spricht mit uns auch über das aktuelle Projekt, an dem gerade arbeitet.
Right now I'm working on a documentary about the first sanctuary in Germany. It's mostly about cows, and I'm trying to portray the lives of cows, because cows are really not an animal that's well known to a lot of people. They know them from drinking their milk or eating them on a burger. So I really want to look in the lives and the emotional lives of cows and make them a bit more known to people, so they can see what creatures they really are.
Marks Botschaft an die Führer unserer Welt in Bezug auf den Übergang ihres Landes hin zu einem mitfühlenden landwirtschaftlichen System ohne die Ausbeutung von Tieren bringt es auf den Punkt.
I think it's really important for governments to create incentives for people that they have access to healthy food, and also that these alternatives are not expensive to them. So helping create these incentives by, for example, through tax regulations or pricing foods that are not as healthy. So that can be one alternative. And then I think it's really crucial that governments act on this, because animal agriculture influences or has an effect on so many trends that we see right now: climate change, destruction of our forest, and health, the nation's health, and of course the welfare of animals. So I think it's really key that our leaders and governments act on this.
Unsere liebevolle höchste Meisterin Qinghai hat auch einschlägige Botschaften an die Regierung der Welt zu diesem Thema übermittelt.
Everybody's worried, but little is done. What we need now is action. Action from the government to inform people and to reinforce the new life-saving diet. That's a vegan diet. I hope the government would please make it into law to forbid killing of animals, to forbid animal livestock raising. If they are truly the leaders that pledge to protect their people, to improve their country in many aspects, then this is the first step we have to do. Stop the meat industry, stop the fish industry, stop the dairy industry. Then our planet will be the way it was and even better. Peace has to be created in the home first, from our table. That's why I have told you from beginning already, vegetarian diet.
Wir sind Mark Kirscher sehr dankbar für sein Engagement und seine Liebe zu den Tieren und dem Planeten sowie für die viele Zeit und Energie, die er in die Dokumentarfilme investiert hat, um die Menschen aufzurütteln und für seine Vision von einer veganen Zukunft voller Liebe und Respekt vor den Tieren. Wir hoffen, dass Sie von Marks Vision und seinen unermüdlichen Bemühungen durch seine Filme inspiriert wurden, mit denen er versucht, Bewusstsein und Verständnis für eine mitfühlende vegane Lebensweise zu wecken. Weitere Informationen über Mark Pürschel und seine Dokumentarfilme finden Sie unter markpürschel.org. Warmherzige Zuschauer, danke, dass Sie unsere heutige Sendung gesehen haben. Es folgt Neue Buddhas sind geboren, Teil 4 von 4. Inzwischen Meisterinnen und Schülern nach bemerkenswerten Nachrichten. Möge Gottes Liebe Sie auf allen Ihren Wegen begleiten. Warm-hearted viewers, thank you for joining us for our program today. Coming up next is New Buddhas are born, Part 4 of 4, on Between Master and Disciples, right after noteworthy news. May God's love be with you wherever you go.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/VE.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule et suprememastertv.com/VE.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule y suprememastertv.com/VE.
Nossos programas oferecem vários idiomas. Acesse suprememastertv.com/schedule e suprememastertv.com/VE.
हमारे कार्यक्रम पेश किए जाते हैं कई भाषाओं में कृपया देखें suprememastertv.com/schedule और suprememastertv.com/VE
我们的节目提供多种语言，请看 suprememastertv.com/schedule 和 suprememastertv.com/VE。
Rancangan kami menawarkan banyak bahasa. Sila kunjungi suprememastertv.com/kehadapan-schedule dan suprememastertv.com/kehadapan-VE.
Barang misyonah mutawafira biladidi minal lughat. Yurja ziyaret suprememastertv.com/schedule wa suprememastertv.com/VE.
Наши программы предлагают много языков. Пожалуйста, посмотрите suprememastertv.com касающийся/schedule и suprememastertv.com касающийся/VE.
साडे प्रोग्राम पेश करते हैं अनेक भाषावां कृपा देखो suprememastertv.com/schedule अते suprememastertv.com/VE